welcome to your primetimesports.com. Our basketball game tonight will be the Armorel Tigers hosting the Marmaduke Greyhounds. I'm Dave Grimm. Alongside me, as always, Clifton Garmrath.
Hello, buddy.
And you have you've been all over the place today, haven't you?
All over the place.
But you made it here in time.
And we're only seven. We're as high in the gym as we can get. Seven
That's right.
bleachers high.
That's right. It's not a very big gym, folks. So that means that our cameraman, Corey Smith, will be
right on top of the action.
That's right. They may pass him the ball. He's right close to it. So we are about to get this one underway. It's one game here tonight, senior boys game. And we'll have some more doubleheaders later on in the season. In fact, when we get the 5A East action, it'll be all doubleheaders. Now, these two teams have met already. In fact, it was last week, and it was at Marmaduke. And the Greyhounds took care of business and won that game 73-61. Marmaduke 2-2 on the season so far in this very young 2012-2013 basketball season. Armorel 1-4 so far on the season. They are announcing the Armorel starting lineups right now. And as soon as they get that done, we're going to get underway for our only game on tap tonight.
Well, I know one thing. I got here in time just to see, what, three quarters of the junior high contest. And their Armorel junior high looked pretty doggone good.
Almost ran Marmaduke out of the building. They ended up winning 50.
Mercy ruled them.
52-14 or something like that it was.
They had a big kid that looked really good for them. They had a couple of big kids.
Yeah, and, you know, so Armorel's trying to build on that. Those guys are probably ninth graders. They'll be on this senior high team. They told me, I had to talk to the athletic director before the ball game, Scott Smith, no relation to our cameraman, Corey Smith, and he said that the senior high Armorel team is a heavily relies on the perimeter shot. They shoot a lot outside the arc, and if somebody guards them, they have trouble.
Well, you can tell they're not all that big. Their junior high is almost as big as their senior high as far as a couple of the inside post players that the junior high team had.
Well, we're about to find out. We haven't seen either of these teams play so far this season. We've only had one game, one basketball broadcast for you so far in this young season. We have talked to Steve Smith on Double G Sports Talk Saturday. And, Steve Ritchie on Double G Sports Talk Saturday, the head coach of the Marmaduke mm-hmm. Greyhounds. And he said they had a great team this year and could compete with anybody, and they still may end up seventh in their conference because that conference is so deep with talent.
That conference is loaded.
So we're about to get this one underway. I'm going to put the scoreboard up for you, Clifton. Tip is controlled by Armorel, and they immediately take it to the basket and no go there. Let me break out my trusty roster. Ahead it goes to Eddie Page. And now from the free throw line extended, that shot won't go for Chris Jones. It's going to be out of bounds. Last touched by Armorel. It'll be Marmaduke basketball. Very early in this game. Nobody has scored yet. Marmaduke ball. They're trying to find somebody to inbound it to. And it's picked off. Picked off by Zach Gray.
Good hustle.
Ahead it goes, and we're going to have a whistle and a foul. He was going to make an easy basket.
Be a foul on see his name there.
Which one?
21.
21 is Nathan Hickson. And Trong was the one that was fouled. It was on the floor, so they inbound the basketball. And now from the perimeter, here's a three-pointer on the way. No good for Peyton Brown. Tracked down by Armorel, but keep it alive. In the paint. Brown loses a handle. Marmaduke comes up with it.
Well, the young man had the right idea. Just that pass was just a little bit too low.
Greyhounds basketball. Up top with it is number 24, Eddie Page. Gives it right side to Chris Jones. Back up top, Will Winberry. Now Hickson. Now back up top it goes to Casey Riggins. They were just working it around the perimeter, trying to find a hole in the Armorel defense. Hickson has to track that one down, but he does. Works it in the corner. Or on the sideline, rather, to Jones. Now from the free throw line, Reagans pops one up and in, and that is the first points scored in the ball game. It's 2-0 Marmaduke.
Both teams in a man-to-man defense.
Armorel with the basketball now. Josh Roberts up top with it. Now down in the corner it goes to Peyton Brown. I said the wrong name a minute ago anyway. We'll correct that just momentarily. Long two-pointer won't go for Brandon Rydell. And it's rebounded by Marmaduke. Greyhound basketball. Reagans thought about the three, thought better of it, dumps it down low. Inside it goes. He's battling for position. He puts it up. He can't get it to go. That's Will Winberry. And so now it's Armorel basketball. And the give and go there wouldn't go for Peyton Brown.
I believe that foul. Well, they may not have called a foul there. That might have been just out of bounds, yeah.
It's out of bounds, last touch by Marmaduke. Brown will inbound it. Gets it in, and it's knocked out of bounds by the Greyhounds again.
Greyhounds versus the Tigers. Did you do that little research that I asked you about? The name that's used most in the...
No, I haven't got to that yet.
We both said Bulldogs.
I think it's Bulldogs. But I've been wrong before.
Tigers is up there.
Tigers is probably up there. Lions is probably up there. From the low block, it will not go for Brandon Rydell, and it's going to be a foul on the rebound called against Armorel.
It's going to be called against Riggins. And, no, I'm sorry, that's Rydell. Is that right?
That's right. Armorel on the side.
That's a pretty cheap foul on his part.
So now it is Marmaduke basketball. They're trying to get it across the timeline. They finally do. This is Eddie Page.
Armorel plays a really good defense.
Winberry off the glass at the end. That's Will Winberry. We got two Winberries on the team. So now it's 4-0 Marmaduke. And whistle, and I guess, was that a foul or out of bounds?
Out of bounds.
Out of bounds. I had my head turned down. Out of bounds. Last touch by Armorel. It's Marmaduke basketball.
You know, Page here from Marmaduke, he looks to be their biggest player. He's the point guard bringing the ball down. He's doing it all.
Gives over to Jones. And back up top to Reagans. Reagans being guarded very closely by Rydell. Now Winberry. Oh, looky here. Three-pointer Page. It's well off the mark, and it's rebounded by Trong. And out of bounds. Last touch by Armorel. 4.5 minutes left to play here in the opening quarter, and it's 4-0 Marmaduke. Now here come the Greyhounds, met at half court by Rydell. No, that's Dallas Nicholson. And now there are two Winberries on the floor for the Greyhounds. That's the other one, Hayden Winberry. And he throws it up top to Will Winberry. Now Page in the paint, spins, puts it up, has his shot blocked. No call, no whistle. Armorel comes away with it, going the other way. Brown. Cross-court pass. Rydell, long two, won't go. Rebound, Winberry. Will pulls it down, gets it ahead to Page. In the corner, Reagans for three. Can't get it to drop. Rebound, Armorel. Trong pulls that one down. Armorel yet to score a point here in this ball game. 3.5 minutes left in the first. Trong up top of the key. Now gives right side to Nicholson. Now back up to Brown. Now Zach Gray with the basketball. Brown thought about a three. Now picks up his dribble. Hands it off. Nicholson for three. It's not going to go. Rebound. Reagans going the other way. Hayden Winberry with the basketball. Pops it at the free throw line. Extended. In and out. No good. Rebound Armorel. And a whistle and a timeout is going to be called by the Armorel Tigers. It's a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it right here.
All right.
We're going to be doing our last football game of the 2012 season this Friday night. We're going to go all the way down to Forest City, Arkansas for a game with major playoff implications.
You are? You going all the way down there?
You're not going?
Oh, I don't. I'm just messing with you.
Oh, okay. Forest City hosting the Blytheville Chickasaws. And Forest City trying to stay in the playoff hunt. They're actually in the top four right now. They're trying to keep it that way.
Somebody asked me this just last night. If Forest City was to lose,
then BB would have an inside track if they won.
But if they lost,
then Blytheville and Paragould would probably be the teams. I don't think Forest City can lose and stay in the playoff picture.
If Forest City or if Blytheville, I'm sorry. Well, we'll talk about that in a minute.
Yeah. Meanwhile, back here on the basketball court, Armorel has the ball after the timeout. And Zach Gray, cross-court pass over to Lane Finley. Finley in the paint, spins and puts it up from the paint and can't get it to go. He draws the first shooting foul of the basketball game and the opportunity to put the first points on the board for the Armorel Tigers.
Now, while he's coming to the line, I'll ask my question again. If Blytheville loses, yes. Forest City loses.
Forest City and Blytheville can't both lose. They're playing each other.
Okay, I'm sorry. If Forest City loses, BB loses.
Paragould's in. No, Paragould's in. No, Nettleton has to lose also.
Yeah, but Nettleton's playing.
Win. Yeah, good luck with that, Nettleton. He made both free throws, 4-2, 2.5 left in the first. And a whistle and a foul on the floor called against Armorel. Our scoreboard, which Clifton is falling down on over here, is sponsored by Big Top Flea Market of Paragould. Marmaduke basketball inbound, up and in, and count the bucket and draws the foul. That is Reagans who gets the bucket.
I'm getting there, buddy.
There you go. And the free throw also good. 7-2. Marmaduke.
You been out to Big Top Flea Market?
I have. Yes, I have. I was out there looking for something. It's a big old place. You got a place in there, right?
Yeah.
Armorel basketball from the corner. That's Ty Wagoner. And he cross-court passes it over to Peyton Landon. There's a different lineup out there on the floor right now for Armorel. Looks like five different guys than was in there before.
I believe you're correct.
Wagoner tries to throw it inside. It's picked off by Reagans. Page all the way down the other end of the floor, puts it up and in.
Nice move by Page. Nice drive.
9-2. Marmaduke. From the paint, that shot's not going to go for Peyton Brown. It's rebounded by Winberry. Hayden Winberry, that is. And we're going the other way. Marmaduke ball down low. It goes to Will Winberry, and he is fouled. That's debatable as to whether or not he was shooting.
I think it's on baseline.
They're going to say on the floor. That is team foul number 4 against Armorel. They're going to inbound the basketball. Hayden Winberry inbounds to Will Winberry. He has to track it down, but does. Now Page. Page from the low block puts it up over the rim and into the hands of the waiting Ty Wagoner, going the other way.
Wagoner looks like a football player.
He probably would be if Armorel had one, a football team. That shot up and in off the assist from Wagoner. That's Lane Finley.
He looks like he'd make a good running back, low to the ground.
Yeah, that makes it 9-4. We're under a minute to play here in the first quarter. Reagans on the wing. Skip pass, now up top. Hayden Winberry for three. It's not going to go in. And it's going to be rebounded by Armorel. We're down to 45 seconds left to play. Trong pulls down the rebound for the Tigers. And now they look like they may hold. They're holding up right there at half court with 35 seconds left to play. He's trapped. And there's going to be a whistle. Are they going to call a foul or timeout or what? They're calling timeout. He called a timeout in that deep hole he was in over there. And let's see if it's a 30.
Now,
yes.
He's not in the game. I was going to ask a question.
Oh, okay.
Trong.
Trong.
I think that's his dad over there.
Maybe. Maybe.
They look just alike.
Yeah, they do. No, I checked the
Did you check his
the
name
pronunciations before the game.
Well, you did good.
And I, of course, I knew all the Marmaduke ones. We had those most of those kids last year on your primetime sports
Winbury
radio, and now you can see them here on your primetime sports television.
Boy, you promote the heck out of that, don't you?
Yes, I do. We're gonna have somebody that we had on radio last year interviewed tomorrow on television, and they'll be able to see her. You know who I'm talking about?
Yes, I do.
I'm gonna interview her tomorrow. We'll play that on Saturday.
Good. We finally got her.
Got her pinned down.
Got her pinned down. She had a sale this past weekend.
I think we got another timeout. Yeah, we got a timeout this time called by Marmaduke, and again, it's a 30. We'll keep it here primarily on the 30s and take the timeout on the minutes. And so it's still 9-4 here. First quarter trying to expire, but it hasn't yet. They're down under 30 seconds left in this first quarter. We'll take a break in between the quarters for sure.
Now, was this a full timeout?
No, it was a 30. You know how you tell? If they're standing up out on the floor, it's a 30. If they're sitting down on the bench, it's a 1 minute.
Okay.
26 seconds left to play here in the opening stanza. It is Marmaduke basketball leading 9-4. And Page gets the inbound pass. Down to 20. He's walking it down. Now 15. They pull the trigger on the offense. Winbury dribbles left side of the floor. He's got 10 seconds on the clock. Now Page. Cross-court pass, 5 seconds left. Now Page fires it with 3 seconds left. It's off the mark. Rebound is going to be Armorel as time expires. We have the first quarter in the books. It's 9-4. Marmaduke will be back in 1 minute on yourprimetimesports.com.
At First National Bank, you have convenience right at your fingertips. And instant buying power. It's so easy. And when you're on the go, well, you know what to do. We understand the importance of now. First National Bank, the working bank for working people.
Do you need insurance? If the answer is yes, let Chris Robinson and his staff at Chris Robinson's Insurance Agency handle your needs, whether it's auto, life, business, or planning for your retirement. Chris Robinson's Insurance Agency is ready to serve you and your family. Come by Chris Robinson Insurance Agency, 1211 West Court Street in Paragould.
Welcome back to your primetime sports. .com. We are in Armorel, Arkansas. Quarter number two about to get underway. Marmaduke leading 9-4 over the Armorel Tigers. We're back underway. This is Page up top. Picked off. Picked off by Lane Finley going the other way fast. Finley puts two on the board for the Tigers. It's 9-6. Greyhound basketball. Left side of the floor, that is Nathan Hickson. Now up top to Reagans. Right side, Page. Back up top, Winbury for long three. It's short. Offensive board pulled down by Bopp. Trey Bopp pulled it down, but then he lost it. It's Armorel basketball.
Armorel has a chance to tie this game up.
This may be one of the coolest names I've ever said on the air.
Bopp.
Trey Bopp.
Trey Bopp.
We can make a song. Trey Bop, bop, bop,
oh,
Trey
boy.
Bop.
They could have back in the 60s, 50s.
Well, there was a song in the early aughts called Mbop, and I was just using the same music. It is Armorel basketball. Zach Gray has it now. Up top, the three-pointer is on the way. It's not going to go for Landon. It's rebounded by
Marmaduke.
Got
a good look at it.
Kind of died on the back of the rim. Oh, dump pass all the way down low, up and in. What a pass.
By Page.
From Page to Hickson. It is 11-6. Armorel basketball. He made his way finally across the timeline. Wagoner to the low block is fouled as he goes up. And Ty Wagoner is going to shoot two with 6:32 remaining in the first
that
half.
That foul was committed by your favorite name, Trey Bopp.
Trey Bopp. I love it. I love it. Free throws now pending. Wagoner missed the first one. Our next basketball game, Clifton. Our next basketball
game
is...
Winbury entering back in the game.
Okay. 1 week from tonight, our next basketball game will be at Manila. The Buffalo Island Central Mustangs against the Manila Lions.
As long as you keep all of them on that side, because I'm in West Memphis and Marion on Tuesdays.
That's it. You can get to that. You can make it to that.
I made it to this one.
Yeah.
It was that one last week that killed me.
Well, I don't know if they're all going to be that count on Tuesdays. We'll just have to see. He missed both free throws, but Armorel comes away with the offensive rebound. And they, oh, that little girl about got any action right there. Did you see that?
Yeah, I did.
It was out of bounds. Last touch by the Tigers. It'll be Greyhound basketball. That's also election night next Tuesday.
I've already voted.
So have I.
I'm done.
I'll ask you who you voted for later.
No, you won't.
Greyhound basketball. This is Paige. Now Winbury. Two Winburys out there. We've got a whistle. It is a foul.
It's going to be on the floor by number 24 on Armorel.
And that's the sixth team foul against the Tigers. Should be. If they change the board. It said five before he called the foul. Should be six. Greyhound basketball. New player in the game. That's Chris Jones. He was a starter. He just now returned.
Well, they have the bonus lights on both of them.
They
and
do.
One of them's only showing four.
Yeah, I don't know. Winbury missed the shot. Page, his one, though, and it's rebound out of bounds. Last touch by Marmaduke. It'll be Armorel basketball.
Bop was wanting the call to go Marmaduke way, but he actually knocked it out.
5-5-5 up there on the timekeeper. 5:55 left to play in the second quarter. And it's Armorel basketball. And it's picked off by Hayden Winbury. Page ahead to Jones. Jones baseline, puts it up, can't get it to drop. Will Winbury got it, and then he went up and down with it. He got bailed out. They're going to say he got fouled. He went up and down with it.
He was pushed from behind.
He's going to get the shoot,
just
two on that deal.
Just in case we get a dunk or anything, do you have our
I have
replay?
Adjusted the instant replay for basketball.
Look at you.
It's what I do, brother. Free throw.
I had to remind you Friday night.
12-6 after the first free throw.
Through a text message.
Yeah, but I did it.
You did. You got it.
You going to be at the football game this Friday?
Yeah.
Okay. Missed the second one. Rebounded by Armorel. Pulled down by David Turner. First time we've called out his name tonight. Tiger basketball. Turner has it. Kicks it back out. Three-pointer is going to be on the way. He had it. Open look by Lane Finley. He got it. Makes it a 12-9 ball game.
That's first three-pointer of the night.
First three-pointer for either team. Marmaduke basketball. Jones. To Riggins. Now Page. Page dumps it down low. Will Winbury off the glass and in.
Well, that was just a good play on Page's part. He penetrated to the basket, drew the defense toward him, two men, and then dumped it down low to Winbury.
And there's another layup. This one will not go for Turner. And it is rebounded by Marmaduke. Reagan. Winbury, three-pointer off the mark for Hayden Winbury. Page gets the rebound, tries to dump it inside with a no look. Winbury there to clean it up. Will Winbury puts it off the glass and in. He scored the last four in a row. 16-9. And that one's out of bounds. Last touch by a red jersey. At halftime, there's supposed to be some cheerleaders performing. We'll have that for you. The Armorel Tigerettes.
I was going to tell you, you wasn't up here at halftime of the junior high game. They had, you could shoot for a dollar.
Yeah.
I don't know what you got for a prize. The first kid went out there in half court. Nothing but net.
Real kidding. Five, did he call 5 seconds? He sure did. He held on to that too long out of bounds, and Marmaduke will get it. Of course, you saw my half-court shot last
week. I wish I wouldn't even have brought it up.
You brought it up.
One-handed football pass, drilled it.
Boom! It's not the first time I've done that.
I know.
16 to 9, rather.
You've told me that.
Paige, travel with the basketball. You can't do that. 4:09 left here in the first half. Tigers making some adjustments on their lineup, and we'll get back underway as soon as that is complete. Inbound pass will be from Finley. He gets it into Gray, and we're back underway. Almost picked off by Jones. Down low to Trong. Off
good
the glass. Can't
go.
Get it to go. Wow. Pulled down by Will Winberry, and ahead it goes to Reagans. Only one Winberry out there on the floor right now, so I can stick to the last name. And he just made another layup. He's made the last 6 points in a row now for the Greyhounds.
Marmaduke starting to pull away here in the first half a little bit.
18-9 the score now. They've doubled up the Tigers. Down low, picked off by Winberry. Ahead it goes to Page. Now Jones. Jones for three. It's short. Plucked out of the sky by Reagans. They're going to say he was fouled over the back on the floor. That is going to be
fouled by Gray.
Team foul number 7 should be 1-1. Yes, it is. So at the line will be Casey Reagans to shoot the 1-1. And for some reason, we're a little bit off on our score. I'm going to fix that now. 18-9 the score. And now it's 19-9. Made the front end of it, made the back end of it. 20-9, Greyhounds. Long pass ahead to Trong. Trong tries to dump it, and it is up off the glass, no good. Offensive board put back up, that one's no good. Rebounded by Winberry of the Greyhounds. Ahead it goes to Reagan. Reagan's on the run with it. Spins in the paint. Puts it up. He draws the foul. He'll shoot two more.
Well, Armorel cannot afford to have those type of shots missed right there if they want to get back into this basketball game. And then where they were playing good defense early in the game, they've come down the last three trips on the floor, and it's been a little hack and knock to the floor.
It's been the Will Winberry show down there. Reagans makes another free throw. That's three free throws in a row for him. 21-9. We're going to have these Greyhounds on again a few more times during the course of the season. He made both free throws. That's 22-9. Our full basketball schedule is up. You can see that anytime you want on yourprimetimesports.com. Trong lost it out of bounds. Oh, they're going to say it was tipped out by a red jersey. They're going to say that Nathan Hickson got a hand on it.
Armorel is making one too many passes. They have some opportunities down low, and they're kicking it back out.
Back underway, Trong in the corner. Up top it goes to Brown. Now in the corner, Gray, it won't go.
Good rebound by Trong. That's going to be a defensive foul on Winberry. It looked like pushing with his hip.
Team foul number 6 against the Greyhounds.
Page entering the game again for the Greyhounds.
I'm not sure if that was the 5th team foul or 16th foul. They're a little slow on the button over there at the scoreboard, so we'll just have
to. Well, obviously it was the 5th foul. They had 4 up there, and they've changed it 1.
Brown for 3, missed it. Winberry pulls it down again. Greyhounds ball. We're down to 2.5 minutes left here in the first half. Page takes it. Can't get it to go. It's short. It's on the out of bounds. Last touch by Armorel. Now, Hayden Winberry can't get the 3 to drop. Page rushes in there to get the rebound, has it knocked out of his hands. It will still be red basketball.
What if Paige is a move-in this year? I don't remember hearing from last year.
I don't either.
I'll find out.
Inside to Reagans, and Reagans loses it out of bounds. Armorel basketball. I don't know what happened there. He must have stepped on the oh, he carried the basketball. Okay, we were talking off camera, and we missed that turnover. He carried the basketball, gave it back to the Greyhounds. Threw it into Reagans. Reagans wasn't waiting for it. Now we've got a whistle and a foul against Reagans on the loose ball.
Now, the reason we don't remember young Eddie Page is because he was on the junior high squad last year, but this is his third year at Marmaduke.
I see. Yeah, we didn't do junior high.
What we got going on here?
Oh, I don't know. We got it fixed now. Back underway. Armorel ball. Brown. Now up it goes to Finley. Now inside the paint, the shot goes up, and Rydell can't get it to go. He draws the
foul on Winberry.
That's two on Will Winberry here in the last couple of possessions for the Tigers. And they don't need to lose him. He's been their offense in the second quarter.
Offense and defense. Been pulling down some defensive rebounds.
Rydell made the first free throw. Stand up. 2 minutes, well, 1:59 to be precise, here in the first half. He got them both. 22-11 now. Marmaduke with the 11-point lead, and they've got the basketball as the second half, the second quarter winds down. Up top it goes. Now, over on the wing, Hayden Winberry can't get the free throw to drop. And it's going to be a jump ball on the rebound, the arrow pointing at Armorel. Ninety seconds remaining in the first half. Brown, three, won't go. Over the back is going to be called on that one. That one all day long is an over the back
call. Gray, I believe.
Against Rydell.
Oh, right, okay.
And we're going to go down here and shoot a 1-1. Yeah, Marmaduke, one of the teams that is in our extended coverage in basketball. We cover the 5A East, but we cover a few more than that in basketball. And Marmaduke is one of those teams. Rector is one of those teams. CRA, one of those teams. Made the first free throw. It's Trey Bopp at the line. And they're going to say he got into the lane early, so whether he'd made it or not, it wouldn't have mattered.
Yeah, he missed it anyway. It was already up and out of the rim.
Armorel basketball.
Marmaduke may have got the rebound.
Brown in the corner. Now inside it goes. Wagoner battles, puts it up and in. Back to a 10-point deficit, 23-13. 1 minute to play in the half. Page got his own rebound, put it back up and in. Nice play for Eddie Page. That one was knocked out of bounds.
I'd like to. I didn't do it quick enough. Seen an instant replay on that one.
It's hard to do instant replay in basketball while play is still going on.
I know, but I'd like to have seen whose foot that really went off of.
Oh, I see what you mean.
But I'm not sure that was the right call.
Well, Marmaduke ends up with it. They're the beneficiary of that call. And that's going to be batted off the referee and still in play. Charging.
It's
got to
be a charge.
Because
he lowered that shoulder.
Finley ran flat over the defender, number 23, Chris Jones.
I'm not sure that Jones was set, but Finley lowered that shoulder and just said, I'm coming through.
Marmaduke They're not going to. They're not going to let.
Going to let Page come, back in.
He didn't check in properly. The ball was already handed off to the other players. 30 seconds left here in the half. Marmaduke basketball. Jones is fouled. That was a little bitty ticky-tack touch foul called on Wagoner, and I believe the referee did that so that Page could get back in the game. left in the half. Score 25-13, Marmaduke.
He's still not letting him in the game.
Wow. I think he's going in for the shooter. Jones.
Now they can come in.
Okay, yeah, you're right, because it's a two-shot foul. Yeah. They don't let you in until after the first shot. And finally, Page makes his way back out on the floor. Reagans will have a seat for the Greyhounds. 26-13, 27-13. Jones makes both free throws. Here come the Tigers. In this game, not nearly as high a scoring affair as their first meeting was last week in Marmaduke. 27-13 the score. Down to 8 seconds left. Gray gets away, now dumps it off, and the shot is up and in, and count it, and he draws the foul. That's Brandon Riddell, who is going to get the bucket.
Could be a four-point swing for
Armorel. It was only a two-point.
Oh, was it?
So he's going to get the bucket, and he's going to get to shoot a free throw. And he got it. Three-point play for Brandon Riddell. 27-16. 2 seconds left. One. Page at the buzzer. No good. 27-16 is the halftime score. And we will take a break. We'll leave a microphone on so you can hear the action here in the gym. We didn't do that last week. We should have, because I could have heard them cheering from me at my half-court shot. We're going to leave a mic on so you can hear what's going on here in the gym as we take a break for halftime on YourPrimeTimeSports.com.
four shots for a dollar.
Thank you.
Retirement? It's never looked so good. Welcome to Chateau on the Ridge Assisted Living in Paragould, Arkansas. Say hello to fine dining and down-home living, where around-the-clock security and peace of mind are always at your fingertips. And front-row seats to the best shows? They're included. We call it Chateau on the Ridge. You can call it home. Call or visit today to get the whole scoop.
At First National Bank, you have convenience right at your fingertips. And instant buying power. It's so easy. And when you're on the go, well, you know what to do. We understand the importance of now. First National Bank, the working bank for working people.
Do you need insurance? If the answer is yes, let Chris Robinson and his staff at Chris Robinson's Insurance Agency handle your needs, whether it's auto, life, business, or planning for your retirement. Chris Robinson's Insurance Agency is ready to serve you and your family. Come by Chris Robinson Insurance Agency, 1211 West Court Street in Paragould.
Hey, welcome back to YourPrimeTimeSports.com. Second half about to get underway. Our basketball game of the week, our only basketball game this week, Armorel hosting the Marmaduke Greyhounds. Greyhounds lead it by 11, 27-16 as we get back underway here for the second half. And it will be Marmaduke basketball.
Were there three games tonight or just two?
Three. They had a seventh grade game
as well.
That's
what I thought.
And they got a little bit of a late start. That's okay. Gave us more time to get ready. Gave people the opportunity to see an entire Bonanza episode. Winberry could get that shot to drop. It's Armorel basketball now. A whistle and a touch foul against Page. First foul of the second half. And a sub will check in real quick for the Tigers. It's number 11, Nicholson.
Yeah, backcourt.
And now they backcourted it.
Well, I think I'm going to have to disagree with the Armorel coach. He caught it both feet on this side of the floor.
And then went back with it. Yeah, you can't do that.
You cannot do that. I know that the Marmaduke player probably caused all of that to happen by trying to steal the ball, but still.
But that's good defense, yeah, is what that is.
That's exactly right.
Marmaduke basketball. Page tries to dump it down low to Winberry. It is out of bounds, and it's going to be last touch by Marmaduke. That looked like it got batted out by a white jersey, but not so, says the official on top of the play. So now it's Tiger basketball. Right L in the corner. Up top it goes to Gray. Thought about the three. Steps in. Fires a long two. He doesn't get it to go. It's rebounded by Winberry. Page ahead to Jones, who can't get it to go. It's blocked and rebounded by Brown. Out of bounds. Last touch by Marmaduke. Football season about to come to a close. One more game
about
to go.
About to come to a close for us. We did 11 games after Friday night.
One got canceled. Going to end up being 10 games.
That's right. Because of all the rain we've had Friday night.
Yeah, that was a monsoon that weekend.
Actually, we did 9.5.
That's true. The Blyville and West Memphis game that got called at halftime. That three-pointer is well short and out of bounds. It'll be Marmaduke basketball. It's been a good football season and a great 5A East race for those last two playoff spots. And it's not over.
One thing for sure, we're in the basketball season now.
Yeah.
Unless their roofs leak, we won't have any rainouts.
That's true. That's true. Unless the roof comes off of this thing. So now, down low, the shot won't go for Reagans. He is fouled. He'll shoot two.
Yeah.
We might have some weather-related, like snow or ice, that calls school off, and they'll call some games off for that, but they'll just reschedule.
Well, sure.
Reagans makes a free throw.
But we'll know that before we leave the house.
That's true. That's very true. 28-16. He made them both. 29-16. Here come the Tigers, trying to get something going offensively. Driving through and can't get it to go is Gray. Rebounded.
Wide open.
This is going to be Jones. If he can dunk it, he will. He can. He lays it off and in. 31-16 the score, and now they have violated the end line and turned it over. That's about the silliest turnover in basketball right there. If you make that turnover, that's – my goodness, they're going to call timeout. Tigers want to talk about this. They're getting out of hand now with 5:59 remaining in the third quarter. It's a full timeout, and we'll be back on yourprimetimesports.com.
Retirement? It's never looked so good. Welcome to Chateau on the Ridge Assisted Living in Paragould, Arkansas. Say hello to fine dining and down-home living, where around-the-clock security and peace of mind are always at your fingertips. And front-row seats to the best shows? They're included. We call it Chateau on the Ridge. You can call it home. Call or visit today to get the whole scoop.
At First National Bank, you have convenience right at your fingertips. And instant buying power. It's so easy. And when you're on the go, well, you know what to do. We understand the importance of now. First National Bank, the working bank for working people.
All right, welcome back. Your PrimetimeSports.com. After the one-minute timeout called by the Armorel Tigers to try and stop the bleeding, it's Marmaduke basketball. The press. Well, that's not a press. That's the end of the floor that they're playing on. Oops. Marmaduke ball. Nobody can seem to get a handle on it. Finally, Will Winberry tracks it down. Jones with it on the left wing. Back up top to Winberry. And now number 21, Hickson. Back up top it goes. And whistle on the floor foul.
Five fouled five.
Team foul number two against the Tigers. Brings a whole new meaning to the term 5-on-5. Five fouled five.
Yeah. Go back into your cage.
Jones will inbound the basketball. Winberry. Now Jones. 4-3. Nope. Rebound. Marmaduke.
That's just good hustle right there by
Reagans. Now the free throw jumper is good for Hickson. Makes it 33-16. Marmaduke just owning this basketball game. 5:10 remaining in the third. Tigers with the basketball now. Batted by Page, scooped by Winberry, to the rack, off the glass, can't get it to go. Whistle and a foul against Marmaduke on the rebound.
Winberry over the back, he wasn't real excited about that call against
him. Well, that's the three that I know of against Winberry. Might be more.
And good that give shot, and that go was by Armorel.
Hook shot flying through the air for Dallas Nicholson. Makes it 33-18.
What'd you think about that alligator we had tonight?
That was nice. We'll talk about that here in just a second. Stolen away, batted and stolen, and to the rack, off the glass and in for Lane Finley. 33-20 now. Whistle. Timeout is going to be called this time. A 30-second timeout called by Marmaduke.
Well,
yeah, you're
about
right.
About the third time tonight, Armorel's come storming back.
The concession stand here at Armorel sells deep-fried alligator.
They sell
it? Yeah, they can buy it at the concession stand. They're cooking it in a deep fryer somewhere. In the building, they're not cooking it in there. They have to take it.
So does the concession stand also sell fish?
Yes, the catfish, yes.
Wow, and they brought us some out here?
They brought up the athletic director said, hey, y'all want some alligator and some catfish? We said, well, yeah, we'll take some of that. And they brought us a whole plate.
Well, y'all saved me some when I got here.
How'd you like that alligator?
I did. I liked it. First time I ever had it.
Me too. And it was good.
I would have liked to have had it I would have liked to have had it
it was cool.
Hot.
It was cooled down a little bit by the time you got here, yeah. That's what you get for being late there, Chief. You get cold alligator.
All right, Armorel gets the ball because Marmaduke turnover.
And we're back underway. 4.5 remaining here in the third. From the paint, that shot's not going to go for Brown. It's rebounded by Page. Ahead it goes to Winberry. That's Hayden Winberry. He's the only Winberry on the floor right now. And he gives back up top to Page. Now Jones. Picked off and stolen away by Finley. Finley to the rack, puts it up, draws the foul.
Well, I'll tell you what, all of a sudden Armorel has stepped it up a notch, and Marmaduke's having a hard time keeping control of the ball on the offensive end.
And Armorel slowly climbing back in this because of that.
Well, it was 20-16. They could make it, 33-16. They could make it 33-21 now.
But you got to make free throws, and Finley missed the first one with 4:04 remaining here in the third. Missed them both. Rebound Page. Page goes the length of the floor, now dumps it to the wrong color jersey. Armorel basketball.
Marmaduke turnover.
It was kind of a sloppy pass from Page.
Well,
and that shot from the paint won't go for Brown, but he draws a foul and he'll shoot too.
You never want to make that pass up in the air because those are the things that happen right down there. You're up in the air, you have nowhere to go.
Brown missed it. That's three free throws in a row missed by Armorel. In fact, all missed by Brown, wasn't it? Didn't he shoot the other two? Yes, he did.
Mm-hmm.
He got the second one. It is 33-21. Now here come the Greyhounds. Winberry brings it across. Winberry being guarded closely by Brown gives to Jones. Now Reagan's. Dumps it down
good
low. Winberry puts it on the floor, then puts it in the hole.
Very good pass by Reagan.
35-21. Brown looked at it, thought better of it. Now it's loose. And Marmaduke comes up with it. Good hustle by Trey Bopp. Ahead it goes, Jones from the paint off. Well, it didn't even touch the glass. It went up and in. 37-21. And now
Marmaduke
stepping up their defense a little bit.
They're going to call a foul on that one, though, against Page. And that's five fouls here in the second half already against the Greyhounds. Only two so far against the Tigers. Nicholson, long two from the baseline. It won't go, and a foul on the rebound committed by the Tigers. They call over the back on
Surely
Turner.
We've had to surpass the fouls that we had in the first half. The whistle's blowing so much.
Well, we're ahead of the pace of the first half,
yeah.
Yes. Page working against Nicholson, gets it across the timeline. From the baseline, jumper will not go, and it's rebounded by Nicholson. Long pass ahead to Finley. Offensive board, Finley tries again, still won't go. They clear it out, they try again. Gray can't get it to go. There's Finley again, puts it off the glass. It won't go, he finally draws a foul. How many shots
did they
have on that?
Well, that'll bring Coach Ritchie off the bench over there because somebody's not blocking out. There's no reason whatsoever that Marmaduke should have allowed four shots on that one possession.
Three of them by one guy.
Mm-hmm.
And he's on the line, and he makes his first free throw. That's Finley. Makes the score 37-22 with another free throw pending. He got them both, 37-23. And now here come the Greyhounds with just over 2 minutes left to play in the third. Winberry to Page. Page drives in and draws a foul on the floor. Team foul number four against the Tigers. Our first game that we play broadcast or a week ago tonight was Cougars against Cougars. And so I kept having to say their school name rather than their mascot. Finally, I'm relieved to be able to do that tonight, to be able to use the mascot while calling the game. Bop! Can't get it to go.
I think Bop was surprised that he received the ball.
I don't think he was looking for it. And they call a foul on the rebound against the Greyhounds. And that makes it a 1-1. That was team foul number 7 against the Greyhounds.
I've never seen so many baskets missed down low as I've seen tonight. I don't know if it's early in the year. And
trying to shake out the cobwebs maybe. On the line for the Tigers is Peyton Landon. First time we have called out his name tonight. He misses the front end of the 1-1. Rebounded by Bop.
Farmrail could make their free throws. They could have cut this to single digit.
You're absolutely right. It is Jones. Now, Winberry can't get it to go. Rebounded by Armorel, stolen by Winberry. Free throw line extended jumper will not go. Reagan's with the offensive putback. 39-23. Now here come the Tigers. They're going to, almost out of bounds. It was saved. Now stolen away. Jump ball is going to be called. They're going to call the jump before the steal, and the arrow points at the Armorel Tigers with 66 seconds. Say that three times real fast. Remaining in the third quarter.
66 seconds? Seconds?
Yeah.
66 seconds.
See, you can't even do it once.
Yeah, 66. Hey, let me get a little water on
there. You go. Here's the inbound to Landon. Now Gray in the corner. Gray drives and is fouled. And he'll go to the line and shoot a 1-1. One minute left here in the third. Gray going to shoot a 1-1. Missed it. Live ball. Foul on the rebound. Over the back call against Armorel.
And not even 100th of a second came off the clock.
No time came off the clock at all. I mean, they may not even push the button. So it will be Marmaduke basketball. Waiting on a sub to come in. That's David Turner checking back in the ball game for the Tigers. The press is on by the Tigers. They get it into Page. Down under a minute now. Page brings it across against Trom. Winberry. Down low it goes to Jones. He loses it. Turner and Jones battling for it right now. It looks like football right there. Jump ball. Marmaduke will get it on the arrow. I was having flashbacks to a football field right there on that one. With 41 seconds remaining in this quarter, Marmaduke will inbound it. They get it into Page, and he puts up a jumper. It will not go, and it's rebounded by Turner. Long pass ahead to Trong. Now, Landon.
Well, he's in trouble in the corner.
Yeah,
they're going to call that dribble.
With 26 seconds left.
Looks like a full.
Yeah, we'll take it too. Back in 60 seconds on yourprimetimesports.com.
Do you need insurance? If the answer is yes, let Chris Robinson and his staff at Chris Robinson's Insurance Agency handle your needs, whether it's auto, life, business, or planning for your retirement. Chris Robinson's Insurance Agency is ready to serve you and your family. Come by Chris Robinson Insurance Agency, 1211 West Court Street in Paragould.
You get big time savings.
Welcome back to yourprimetimesports.com. The timeout taken with 26 seconds remaining in this third quarter. Armorel basketball. They are down 16 points to the Marmaduke Greyhounds, 39-23. And they inbound it to Landon. Turner kicks it out to Trong, out of bounds, Marmaduke basketball. Starting to get in the basketball rhythm again.
Are you?
Yeah, we got one more football game to get out of the way, and then I'll be there, man.
Then get out of the way. Grim's coming. Basketball action.
That's my thing, man. Down to 10 seconds. Page. Now Winberry drives in, puts it off the glass and in with 4 seconds remaining in the quarter. That will do it.
Well, that was just a good job by Winberry finding that crease and going to the bucket.
41-23, the fourth quarter, when we come back on yourprimetimesports.com.
At First National Bank, you have convenience right at your fingertips. And instant buying power. It's so easy. And when you're on the go, well, you know what to do. We understand the importance of now. First National Bank, the working bank for working people.
Do you need insurance? If the answer is yes, let Chris Robinson and his staff at Chris Robinson's Insurance Agency handle your needs, whether it's auto, life, business, or planning for your retirement. Chris Robinson's Insurance Agency is ready to serve you and your family. Come by Chris Robinson Insurance Agency, 1211 West Court Street in Paragould.
Hey, welcome back to yourprimetimesports.com. Fourth quarter left to play here in this game between the Marmaduke Greyhounds and the Armorel Tigers. And Marmaduke leads it big, 41-23, with Armorel getting the ball to start the final period. New players in the game. All new players in the game. Mostly new. Let's see. This is Chris Hughes. First time we have called his name out tonight.
Who did they call that foul on Winberry, number 15? I'm not sure what he did.
Well, it was away from the ball. The foul was away from the ball. It's Trong on the free throw line, but Hughes had the basketball. So Trong makes the front end of the 1-1. This is the final 1-1, by the way. They'll be in the double bonus from here on in. Missed it. Hughes battles for it. Nope, he doesn't come up with it. Nathan Hickson pulls it down for the Greyhounds. Hayden Winberry gives over to Jones. And whistle away from the ball again. And this time it is against number 14 for Armorel, Peyton Landon. That's two fouls in a row that have been called away from the ball.
Well, I think 14 and 15 on Armorel and Marmaduke are kind of battling one another, and the referees are starting to pick up on it and watch them. Yeah, 14's coming out of the game now.
Hey, Winberry inbounds it to Will Winberry and batted out of bounds. Nice hustle right there by Zach Gray for the Tigers.
Corey right on top of it, right down here below his feet.
That's right.
It's a good thing people are not sitting right there in those stands.
No kidding. Hayden Winberry looking for somebody to inbound it. Finds Will Winberry. Reagan's on the run. Dumps it down to Jones. Jones' shot is blocked out of bounds.
Well, tomorrow's Halloween, last day of the month, man.
Yeah.
We're moving into November.
I'll talk about Halloween here in just a few minutes. I've got little ones. You don't have little ones anymore, but I do. In the paint, Will Winberry off the glass and in, 43-24. Taking Drew to the First United Methodist Church trunk or treat tomorrow night. And the granddaughters as well. All three granddaughters and Drew, my youngest, to First United Methodist Church. There's a three. Brandon right out.
I think there's a few trunk or treats around town. I think First Baptist is having one too.
Apparently it was only a two. They're calling it 26 points on the board. That shot was missed and Armorel pulls down the rebound. 43-26 the score with Armorel trying to climb back out of a 17-point deficit here in the final period. Another three. That one's off. And out of bounds. Marmaduke basketball. Now, your kids are all grown. In fact, you got one just got married Saturday. Is that correct? Or is getting married soon? I must have the dates wrong.
You do.
Page, and there's a foul on the floor before the shot. That is going to be team foul number 7 against Armorel.
Brett,
so now in the bonus are the Marmaduke Greyhounds.
Brett must not have told you that I was at the Metal Arc Lemon.
You went to that with him.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
I didn't
we got
go
some good
with
footage.
Him.
He got some good footage. I
took a bunch of action shots. I'm going to send you some pictures. How come you haven't posted those other ones I sent you of the banquet?
Haven't got to it yet. I'm going to. Page makes a free throw. I'll get to it. There's lots and lots and lots of things on the grim plate. But I did receive the footage today and copied it off. And I have that disc for you as well.
Okay. That's the one that Metal Arc is wanting?
That's right. Made both free throws. 45-26. And the length of the floor, that one goes in for Lane Finley. Armorel hanging around, still down by 17 with 6:10.
Yeah, you've got that little ditty to put in, too,
uh-huh.
For a basketball game.
One of them was great, one of them not so much, and I'll tell you about that later. But one of the two subjects involved didn't say the name of the website right.
I know you're talking about, but we're going to use it anyway.
Are we?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I didn't do anything with it. I wanted to talk to you first.
He's the star.
Is he?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'll do something with it then.
Yeah, the one.
No. The Metal Arc got it right.
Oh, he did?
The other guy
Harrison
got it wrong.
Harrison didn't? Pee-wee didn't?
That's right.
We did it five times.
Missed it.
We can't cut and splice?
No. Only got the one he sent me. I only have one.
Oh.
First free throw, no good.
Well, I know we did it more than one time.
Well, we got Metal Arc good. Second free throw, good.
I'll have Brett check on that.
45-29.
I think you just picked the wrong one because I know the last one was a good one.
Okay, well, the one I got was not. It's okay. We'll see what we can do. Marmaduke basketball. Down low to Will Winberry, who puts it. No, it doesn't go in. It's rebounded by Armorel. Rebounded by Lane Finley, and he's going the length of the floor.
Good
now
pass.
He dumps it to Trong. Trong can't get it to go in. It's rebounded by Will Winberry.
I think he got so excited he was wide open, he just overshot it.
A timeout is called by Marmaduke. You're absolutely right. 5:29 remaining
he's
in the ball game.
He's down there waving his hands. Hey, I'm here. And all of a sudden he got the ball.
Let's take a full timeout. We'll be back on your primetimesports.com.
Retirement? It's never looked so good. Welcome to Chateau on the Ridge Assisted Living in Paragould, Arkansas. Say hello to fine dining and down-home living, where around-the-clock security and peace of mind are always at your fingertips. And front-row seats to the best shows? They're included. We call it Chateau on the Ridge. You can call it home. Call or visit today to get the whole scoop.
You get big-time savings and hometown service.
Welcome back to your primetimesports.com. 5 minutes, 29 seconds remaining in tonight's ball game between the Marmaduke Greyhounds and the Armorel Tigers. Marmaduke leads it big, 45-29. They've got the basketball as we resume play. And they get it into Reagans. Now Page with it up top for the Greyhounds. Marmaduke with a big lead in no kind of hurry whatsoever.
I was on the phone.
Yeah, I had your mic turned down because you were on
see
the phone.
That.
Okay. Hayden Winberry. Now Page from the paint. Puts it up. Can't get it to go. Draws the foul. He'll shoot two with 4:59 remaining. So on election night, we will be at our next basketball game, Buffalo Island Central at Manila, a grudge match in Mississippi County. Actually, BIC is in Craighead County, but parts of that district are in Mississippi County. Got the second free throw. It's 46-29. Hughes, now Finley. Finley tries to dump it down low, gets it back. And now Gray fouled on the floor. Two shots from here on out for Armorel when they get fouled.
Gray tried to get by Jones, and Jones tried to grab him and say, no, you can't go this direction.
Well, Gray is a little feller.
He is a little feller.
And
with a lot of heart.
He's all over the floor, man. He's just everywhere. And he makes the first free throw.
He's been on the floor, up in the stands, on the floor.
Yeah. 46-30 now after the free throw from Gray. He's still got another one coming. In and out, no good. Rebounded by Reagans. Ahead to Page. Page to Jones. Now they're going to set up the offense with 4.5 minutes to play. Page drives down, puts it up and in, and draws a foul. Count the bucket. It will be 48-30. And Page will get to shoot one. Missed it. Rebound by Brown. Tigers down by 18. And they lose it out of bounds. I don't know if they can come back 18 in this amount of time, but they'd like to try and make the score look a little bit more respectable.
A lot of turnovers for both teams tonight.
Long pass ahead. Jones puts it off the glass and in. 50-30, the score now. Armorel can't get that one to go by Finley. Rebound by Marmaduke. We're under 4 minutes to play. Jones, Page from the free throw line, drives in, puts it up from the paint, got it. 52-30.
Now, it's just a walk in the park for Marmaduke.
Yeah, Armorel's not able to stop Marmaduke. Here late in the game, they've run out of gas. This shot will go in for Dallas Nicholson. Makes it a 20-point ball game again.
If I stand
again up,
I need a remote right here.
Yeah. 52-32. You need a tall table like this we can stand up at, like a bar. Marmaduke. Page puts it off the glass in. Marmaduke scoring at will here late in the game. Makes it 54-32. Now here's a three-pointer. That one goes in for Armorel. Peyton Brown knocks down a three. 54-35. I don't know. The scoreboard is wrong. It says 52-35. Should say 54. And they're having to talk about it right now at the scorer's table. Well, we've got the right score here, Clifton. Yeah, don't worry about that.
Young
up there.
Man over there, I think, just told him. I think I read his lips, but that don't mean anything.
The first free throw went in, so it's going to be 55 now, and they still haven't counted that either.
Well, we have the correct score.
We have it on our score. He made them both. Scoreboard is 4 points off on here at the Armorel, but it's 56-35.
Well, he put one up there.
Now Armorel basketball. In the paint, that one goes in for Gray. .220 remaining. Marmaduke still playing like they're right in, like it's a close game. Mm-hmm. Not trying to kill clock. They're still hustling out
there.
Well,
they're just moving the ball.
Wimberry can't make that one go, and it's rebounded by Gray. Now they've corrected the scoreboard, Clifton. Brown for three. Got it.
Where's he been all night long? He's made the last two of those.
56-40. Minute 45 remaining in the ball game. Now they're trying to kill some clock, and Armorel won't let them. They're going to call an offensive foul on that.
He threw his shoulder in there. He wasn't set to set that screen. Probably was his fifth foul.
That's an offensive foul, so it will not result in free throws.
Coach Ritchie over there kind of getting on to him a little bit about that.
90 seconds left to play.
Foul that was uncalled for.
Gray from the paint misses everything, and Winberry pulls it down. That's Hayden Winberry with the rebound. Jones with the basketball. Has it poked loose from behind. It's loose, and Armorel comes up with it. Gray is fouled, and that is a hard foul on the little guy.
A hard foul. But he's going to hop up.
He's a gamer. Gray pops right back up off the floor and heads to the free throw line like nothing ever happened. 56-40 with 70 seconds remaining in the ball game. And Gray, first free throw is good. Missed the second one, and it's rebounded by Bop. I can't wait till we do another Marmaduke game so I can say Bop more.
He may bop you on the head.
Hayden Winberry trying to kill the last minute of time. We're down to 53 and counting. Now Jones playing keep away.
A little curly nail action out there.
Winberry, 40 seconds to play.
Oh, look at that. Between the legs. Nice ball handling.
From the paint, he makes it. Oh, he couldn't get it to go. And it's rebounded by Finley. Armorel has it with 30 seconds left to play. Brown for three. Off the mark. Turner wasn't ready for that rebound. It hit him in the shoulder. And they call a foul on Armorel on the rebound anyway. So they're going to go to the other end and shoot two with 21 seconds remaining in this ballgame. This is Hayden Winberry, who makes his way to the free throw line for the Greyhounds. Got it. And now the fresh jerseys hop off the bench for the last 21 seconds for Marmaduke. So for the last 21 seconds, I got new names to learn for the Greyhounds. Missed the second one. Rebounded by Armorel. Pulled down by Finley. Gray is fouled. He is fouled by one of the new names, Quentin Smith. So he got his name in the scorebook. Not for points, though.
Under the F category.
Under the Gray can't get it to drop. 15 seconds left to play. He got the second one. The fresh jerseys are going to get to have an offensive possession here. Hayden Winberry, the only player with any playing time still in the ball game, killing the last 5 seconds.
No, there's two of them in there. Jones is in there, isn't he?
No. And Winberry in the paint gets it to go. Do they call the charge or do they call the...
Looks like they're calling it on Armorel.
Yeah. Yeah. Count the bucket and one free throw with 0.1 seconds remaining. Kind of overkill at this point. 59-42. Winberry gets to shoot a free throw.
Could he hit the 6-0 mark?
And yes, they did. Does. 60. All they got to do is touch the ball. And it'll be over.
And our scorekeeper over there is off again.
It's okay.
So 60-42 is the right score.
That's right. It's okay. 60-52 and
60-42.
That's right. 60-42. Final score. And, oh, there we are.
Oh. I didn't know you were going to put us on TV.
Oh, well, we haven't been on all night long, so we might as well say hi to the folks. next game broadcast is going to be Friday night from Forest City. First time we've been there for football this year.
I really don't like being this close to you.
That's okay. You don't pay me enough to be this close to you, but that's okay.
True.
I'll get over it. We'll be in Forest City Friday. Blyville and Forest City, final football game of the year. Big time 5A East playoff implications in this game. And then Saturday, we've got a few of the guests already lined up. I don't want to talk about the guests right now. I want to make sure we've got them lined up. But we'll have another edition of Double G Sports Talk Saturday for you on Saturday morning, 8:30. And then our next basketball game will be right here in Mississippi County. It'll be down the road in Manila, the Buffalo Island Central Mustangs facing the Manila Lions. So I believe that'll do it for us tonight, don't you think?
I believe so.
All right, we will
see you. I'm ready to drive home, hit sack.
Okay, yeah, you've had a long day, haven't you? You have been all over creation today.
I see how many counties I've been in today. Green, Craighead. What's Marion and West Memphis?
Crittenden.
Yeah. Crittenden. What's Blytheville, Armorel?
Mississippi.
So four counties out of how many is in the state of Arkansas?
75.
So
not bad. All right, we're going to be done now, and we will see you here for Blytheville Forest City Football on Friday night. Thanks for joining us.